search warrant on stolen property that's been sold here at this establishment. There's been a lot of food, meat that we have sold to these folks. And it looks like for the last couple of years, they've been buying stolen property. We've made a couple of arrests back in August that led us here to this location. People selling stolen goods here, and we feel that it does nothing more perpetuate the opiate epidemic that we're under. And as I said last time, if you're buying stolen property, no matter what it is, in our community, we're going to put you in jail. This search warrant we're executing today was brought about by our organized retail crime unit and our partners in the retail community here in Knoxville. Kroger has been very helpful with us to try to get some of the things that we need. And the Department of Human Services, the Knox County Health Department, the Department of Revenue, and the Sheriff's Office are here today serving that search warrant. And there'll be charges to follow.
Now, this was totally different than the pawn shop, the tire place. What is this place, and how is it different than the other ones?
Well, you know, it is a little bit different because it's food that's been sold. And we know from the informants that we've used that a lot of this food was stolen 10, 11 o'clock at night. It was set in a car trunk all night, sold here the next day, cooked and served to these customers that are coming in here. So, you know, it seems this is a solid business in our community that took a chance on buying stolen property to increase their profits. And, you know, there's no excuse for that except greed. We cannot allow our community to be held up by this drug epidemic, and this does nothing but perpetuate it. And as I've said before, it's an all-hands-on-deck approach to fighting this epidemic that we're under. And we're going to do everything we can. We're very committed, our folks at the Sheriff's Office. The Organized Retail Crime Unit does an excellent job of protecting our people in the retail industry from these types of thefts. It happens every day, time and time again. And from the drug addicts that we've talked to that are helping us now, that are trying to get clean, we know their MO. We know what they do. They get up every morning and they start stealing. They steal all day, 7 to 10 times a day. It's not just once that they're going out stealing. They're doing this 7 to 10 times a day for their addiction. And when you're buying this stuff from these drug addicts, you're perpetuating that addiction. You know, from all throughout East Tennessee, and now really the country, this opiate epidemic is on the forefront of every newscast, every newspaper. You don't have to go far to turn on any news broadcast across this country and see how this is destroying lives. And if you're going to do this type of crime, if you're going to buy stolen property in our community, you need to look over your shoulder because we're coming. We're not going to put up with it. We're committed to try to stop this epidemic from every way we can, through education, through incarceration, if we have to, and through investigation. Our folks are doing a bang-up job, and we're not going to quit. This is not the last time that we're going to be called out on a search warrant where I tell you that somebody's going to jail for buying stolen property. I assure you of that.
Can you say how long it's been going on at this store?
You know, they've been doing this from the people that we arrested for a couple of years. They've been buying stolen property. This investigation here has been going on since August. So, you know, it's sad, you know, that this community market has failed into that. But it's not surprising. You know, we've seen it. You know, we've been out and we've seen it. We've not seen it at a restaurant like this, but you know, we've seen it at other stores and things that we've done, pawn shops and stuff. But you know, this is kind of a new trend. But our retailers we work great with, they're on board with us, trying to help us stop some of the thefts that they're seeing. And look, it cost all of us money. It cost all of us money. And buying meat that's been sitting in a car all night, serving it to the, you know, Knox County public, could cost us a lot more. It could cost somebody their health.
What kind of, I guess the proprietors of this place are facing some pretty serious charges then? Or?
Yes, felony charges will be placed soon, and we'll get those to you as soon as the warrants are served. Kroger's Loss Prevention folks, they fight this every day, just like any other retailer, okay? So they partner with us, they give us things to sell as if they are stolen. And our confidential informants and our undercover officers will then go out and sell it, you know? And it's we know who's buying it because the drug addicts that we have arrested are telling us where they're taking their stolen goods. You know, we had 408 people that accounted for over 5,000 pawn tickets or gift card sales. So there's a direct correlation between those types of thefts and the drug epidemic that we face. And it is, again, it's an all hands on deck approach from our retailers, our partners here that we have in Knox County, you know, every facet of county government. You know, we got the health department, Department of Human Services, Knoxville Police Department, Knox County DA's office. We're all working together, famously, to try to combat this epidemic that we're under. And I tell you, it ties right back to drug use.
What's the name of your retail?
It's the Organized Retail Crime Unit. That unit was started 6 years ago as a part-time unit. And it has morphed into a full-time standalone unit at the sheriff's office. We have detectives that work in there every day to combat retail crime.
And they purchase meat from some of your undercover officers?
Yes, sir.
What practices can businesses locally take to prevent accidentally buying a stolen good? Is it possible to do it on accident?
I do not believe it's possible to do it on accident. If you are a restaurant like this, you have to buy your goods that you sell from a reputable dealer where you can track that meat. If that meat is tainted in some way, they have to know how to go back and track that. The Department of Human Services is in because EBT cards are being used here. So, you know, that's taxpayer money, you know, that's being used here to perpetuate crime. We can't have it. We're not going to have it. And we're very committed at the sheriff's office to doing everything we can to combat this in every single way. As I mentioned, all hands on deck. So our entire community has to be involved in this. Everybody has to work together. This is nothing that we're going to come out from under in the next 2 weeks. We didn't get this way overnight. You know, it took years to get this epidemic crisis, and it's going to take years to get out of it. But we all have to work together to do it. And when you have a retailer like this who is buying stolen property from drug addicts, he has to know that the money he's giving them is perpetuating the drug epidemic. And we are going to do everything we can to stop it.
So you're going to be charging with affidavit, not for grand jury?
Correct.
That's facing the charges? Or?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So is it more than one individual you expect to charge?
I don't think so, Don. I think we'll just have one individual charged here.
Do you have the name of that gentleman? Or?
I'm not releasing that yet. I'll let them get finished here, and then I'll get that to you guys just as soon as I can, maybe before you leave here today.
But after the employees who work here, they may not necessarily have been involved in that kind of stuff.
Maybe not involved. Maybe they knew. We're working through all that right now. Yeah, it is. Yes, sir. The Knox County Health Department's in here, and they'll make a determination whether to shut the business down or not.
I just wondered, because when they write this up, a little bit more specific, just meat. Was it like hamburger, hot dog? What was there a variety of? Only meats, though.
There's proteins, chicken, beef, you know, hamburger, beef tenderloin.
All that.
All types of beef.
High dollar items. We're not talking about canned yams.
Correct, Don. It's all, you know, proteins.
Okay.
Yeah.
How many different retailers, groceries, was it grocery stores or handling or being victimized?
Yes, sir. You know, product? Food City, Kroger's, the larger retail grocery stores in our area that were being victimized by the thefts. Now, Kroger agreed to help us in the investigation of this. Their loss prevention folks did, and they're here on site and able through barcodes to say, yes, this came from our store. So,
are you actually finding the filtered goods are still in the
yes, sir. Yes, sir.